we are here with Pip Taylor in her beautiful home at Lennox Head. Pip is a triathlete but also a nutritionist. So we're going to ask her a few questions, including some that we've had sent in by viewers about nutrition in elite sport. So Pip, tell us a bit about yourself.
As you said, I'm a professional triathlete. I'm into my 13th year of racing. I actually have an undergrad degree in science, and I followed that up with a postgrad diploma.
One of our viewers' questions, the first one that got sent in on Facebook, which was asked by Kate Swain, she asked about nutrition during long-distance endurance events, saying that she had trouble finding something that she could eat that she could stomach when she was running a long distance.
The most important thing to remember is that your gut is, like anything else, is a muscle within your body. And, you know, we're really not designed to be able to take in food and process it while you're on the move, while you're running, and while your body's under that kind of stress. So it comes back to partly training it. So get used to one or two training sessions a week, set them aside specifically for that, for your nutrition training.
Yep.
So that you're practicing taking in, whether that's your gels or your drinks, or over those longer races again, you might be needing some solid food.
Yep.
So it's just getting used to that.
Definitely.
When it comes to nutrition, just don't overcomplicate things. You know, it's food. It's a pretty simple thing. You eat at least three times a day. So just keep it simple, keep it clean, and don't overthink it too much.
All right. Well, thank you.
Easy.
And yeah, we're just about to get into a boxing session with Matt. So let's go do a workout.
So, why in off season do you like to mix it up with boxing and things like that?
You know, I think it's really important as triathletes we get really, really used to swim, bike, and run, and a lot of that's in one plane of motion. It's also, you know, often triathlon or triathletes are tracing volume, and it's pretty easy to lose sight of some of the basic body fitness and health. I think things like this are really, really good, kind of keep you on your toes and moving in different directions, and you know, it's different athletes and different bodies get fit for one particular thing. So even though you might be fit running, coming and doing a session like this really throws you out of your comfort zone, out of your movements, and it's hard as hell.
Cool. Thanks a lot.
Thanks, Randy.
Awesome.